Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the lecture series of Material Studio, today is our fifth lecture, and in today's lecture we will discuss about modification of material properties, how to modify material properties. Since we know we have so many ways like doping strategies, making heterojunction, heterostructure, layer structure, or changing material morphology. So in today's lecture our main focus will be on doping of material, like mono-doping, co-doping, and tri-doping. About modification material properties, it's crucial for various application. We use strategies like doping, changing internal morphology, heterojunction, and nanostructuring to create materials with the new properties, with novel properties. So by understanding these strategies, we can design and develop material with unique properties to meet specific needs. Why modify material properties? So the answer is, material science aim to create material with specific properties for various applications. Sometimes naturally occurring materials don't meet our need, so we modify their property to make them more suitable. Modifying properties, material properties, can improve performance, enhance functionality, increase efficiency, reduce cost, and enable new application. So as I discussed in start, that strategy to modify material properties are so many, and we will discuss about doping. We know doping introduce impurities to alter electrical, optical, and magnetic properties. And doping involved adding a small amount of foreign substance, doping, to a material. This changes the material properties like conductivity or optical absorption. And we have mono-doping, co-doping, and tri-doping. And in mono-doping, introduce a single doping element, for example silicon doping with boron to create p-type semiconductor. And co-doping, introducing two doping elements simultaneously, for example silicon doping doped with phosphorus and boron to create a semiconductor with novel properties, with the stellar conductivity. And tri-doping introduced three doping elements simultaneously, for example silicon doped with phosphorus, boron, and like iron or cobalt, to create semiconductor with enhanced conductivity and optical response. We have different type of doping, like n-type doping, p-type doping, isoelectronic doping. So let's move toward the screen and see practically how to mono-doping, co-doping, and tri-doping. So for this, firstly we have to make a supercell. We do calculation with unit cell, but you know, for getting average result, we have to make a supercell. So for this, let's make 2×2×1 supercell. For doping, it's enough. It's total 48 atom. Now firstly let's dope single doping, mono doping. So for this, let's select the single oxygen atom, and then in the top menu bar we see a periodic table, and in that we select our desired material, desired element. So let's we select tantalum and then press OK. So we see our oxygen atom is replaced by tantalum. This is called mono doping. And for co doping, let's select another atom. And same process, select from periodic table element, like we have choice Fe, CO, carbon, chromium, we have so many ways. So for this, let's select cobalt and then press OK. If we see that's there, this is a co-doping. And for tri-doping, let's select another atom, either select oxygen and titanium. So we are interesting to replace a titanium atom with Fe. So for this, select Fe iron atom from periodic table and then press OK. So we see firstly we will change we will replace we replace just a single atom and then two atom and then three atom. So this is the basics of Material Studio, and then moving ahead toward the case tip calculation. Open the module of case tip, and then firstly optimize geometry optimization for getting stable structure. So as we know, it's not metal, so we check out this. We are going with the medium quality and function GGA with the PBE. Further, and then apply maximum core. Then just start the calculation. So after geometry optimization, find the desired properties like band gap, band structure, density of state, and optical response. So this is all about doping. If anyone have any question, please feel free to comment. With this, thank you very much.